season is upon us. Yay! And you know what that means? It is time for some bold predictions for the 2021-2022 NHL season. And we need some champs to do that. Let's have some fun and make some bold predictions. First on this list is that the Pittsburgh Penguins will miss the playoffs. So I've made this exact prediction before, and technically I was wrong. Well, it honestly depends on who you ask. I might have been right in some people's eyes because the Penguins did make the qualifying round that year. Whether or not you consider that the playoffs, I did, so technically I was wrong, but maybe you think I was right. But if there was ever a season where I feel like this might actually happen, I think it really is this one. They're starting this season with Jeff Carter as their number one center. So, you know, I think I have some reasons here for saying that they might miss the playoffs. Honestly, I kind of would hate to see this happen because it would mean that I am also officially old. But here we are with me making this prediction. Number two is on the flip side. We have the Seattle Kraken will make the playoffs. I don't know how bold this really is. I mean, they're in a weaker division and Vegas really set the bar high with the expectations for expansion teams. But they have good goaltending and they have okay depth throughout their entire roster. I think if the Kraken were in the Central, we probably wouldn't even be having this conversation, but we're not. They are in the Pacific and here we go. Kraken make the playoffs. Number three bold prediction is that the Islanders will win the President's Trophy. Isles fans, this has got to be weird to be getting all of this love and respect for your team. Does it feel like you've lost your identity a little bit? But winning the President's Trophy comes with a downside. It is cursed. That will ultimately ruin your Stanley Cup dreams. See, we had to end on a bad note so that you guys could go back to yelling and being angry, and that's just the way that nature intended it. Okay, next up, number four is that Columbus gets into the playoffs as a second wildcard spot. I so desperately want this team to go on a Cinderella run. I was in Vegas for that inaugural home opener and I'll just never forget that game and just the way sport kind of helped the city feel like it took a step forward after everything that it went through. And after everything that this team went through in the summer, I just think it would be so incredible to see them go on that type of run and just a really cool way to honor their late teammate Matisse. All right, next prediction, number five. Edmonton makes big moves at the deadline and they become a serious contender. It was great to see the Oilers get some support finally for McDavid and Draisaitl in the offseason, but they are still missing some key pieces if they really want to be a serious contender, namely a defense. Also, their goaltending situation is very delicate. Now, I'm from Philly, so I don't have much room to talk, but let me tell you, that's not an ideal situation you have there. As the season unfolds, it'll tell us a little bit more of what they need, and I predict that they are going to be big time buyers to make a big splash and try to become legit Stanley Cup contenders. I feel like the real way this is gonna go down is they're gonna get your hopes way up, become real contenders, everyone's really picking for them and rooting for them, and then they crush your soul. Had to get a little refill here before bold prediction number six, which is that Marc-Andre Fleury's 15-year playoff streak come to an end. I feel like we don't talk enough about how he has been to the playoffs for 15 straight seasons. I literally just spilled my champagne on myself because that is insane. That was 2006. Instagram didn't even exist then. I was still in high school. We were mourning Steve Irwin's death while listening to the number one hit song, Bad Day. The more I think about it, the more I think this is a terrible bold prediction to root against Marc-Andre Fleury making the playoffs. But I just don't know if Chicago has what it takes in the Central Division. Lastly, before this gets too out of control, number seven, my final prediction is that the 2021-2022 Stanley Cup Final will be between the Florida Panthers and the Colorado Avalanche, with your ultimate Stanley Cup champions, the team that will be hoisting Lord Stanley come June, pending any other crazy shit happening in our world, will be the Florida Panthers. But I feel like there are a lot of good reasons to be picking them to win the Stanley Cup. One is that it's not really a bold prediction if I pick the Avs, Golden Knight, or even Lightning for a three-peat. I also already said that the Islanders will win the President's Trophy, so I have to nix them out of there. Additionally, I find it very entertaining if the Stanley Cup stays as far south as possible, which you know, the furthest team south would be the Florida Panthers. Now for some serious thoughts on this. This is probably the strongest roster they've ever put out there, but most importantly, they have goaltending. Bob hopefully has a bounce back season, but say he doesn't, they still have Spencer Knight, and I think between the two of those goalies, one of them will just get hot at the right time, which we know how important that is in the Stanley Cup playoffs. A hot goaltender, and boom, no one sees it coming. Freaking Florida Panthers hoist Lord Stanley, pissing off every snobby hockey fan. You love to see it. Now that I've said that, I have just cursed us all, and the freaking Montreal Canadiens are gonna win the Stanley Cup, aren't they? So there you have it, guys, my 7 bold predictions for this NHL season. Be sure to let me know what your thoughts are in the comments below. What are some of your crazy predictions? How crazy are my predictions? I'd love to hear your thoughts. And hell yeah, guys, hockey season is here, so cheers to hockey. Nope, not chugging it, not doing that, I'm too old for that.